So the height h of a seat above ground on a Ferris wheel at time t is given by the function h of t equals 30 times sine of pi over 10 times t plus 35, where t is greater than or equal to 0, and t is measured in seconds and h is in feet. We're going to graph this function for two periods, and then we're going to find also the maximum height of the seat. So a couple things to think about, I guess, to get started here. The amplitude will be the absolute value of 30. Well, the absolute value of 30 is just 30. The period will be 2 pi divided by the absolute value of b, but pi over 10 will be the value for b. Well, the absolute value of pi over 10 is just pi over 10. You can flip and multiply. So the pi's will cancel. You'll have 10 times 2, which will be 20. And to get my increments on the x-axis, I take the period for sine or cosine, in this case sine, and I divide it into 4 equal pieces. So 20 divided by 4 will be 5. So that's what I'm going to use. I'm going to go over 5, 10, 15, 20, etc. on my x-axis here in just a second. And let's see, what else? I guess the positive 35, that's going to correspond to a vertical shift. So we'll think about that as well. All right, so let's get going here. Okay, so I'm going to use increments of 5. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and 40. Let's see, so the value, this positive 35, you can also think about that. That's sometimes called the midline. If you think about the line y equals 35, okay, so whatever the value is that's being added or subtracted, if you take y equals that, that line is exactly going to cut your sine function in half. So I'm going to find 35 here. So I probably should have given myself a little more room. That's okay. So we'll pretend the h of t axis, or the y axis, is in units of 10. So 10, 20, 30. There will be 35. So from there, if you think about the amplitude, which is 30, if you go 30 units down, we'll be at 5. And from that midline, 35, y equals 35, if you go up 30 units, we'll be at 65. So let's see, 2 full ones and a little bit more. So there will be 65. My sine function is going to be trapped in between that little tube. So it'll bottom out at 5, it'll top out at 65, and that's one way I like to think about these, because it kind of gives me some symmetry. It tells me to go above it and below it and keep things equal. So what you can do now as well is just always plot some points, and that's what I'm going to do here. So if you plugged in, for example, t equals 0, you would have sine of 0, which is 0. So we'll start out right at 35. And if you think about the normal sine function, you know, just sine of x, it goes up, and then it comes back down, and then it goes down, and then it comes back up. This function's going to do the exact same thing. The value out front of sine is positive, so it's still going to increase. So if you want to, I mean, again, you can always plot some points. You can plug in t equals 5, t equals 10, t equals 15, etc., to make sure that you are getting the right values. But that's what's going to happen. At t equals 5, we'll be up here at 65. At t equals 10, we're going to be back down here at 35. At t equals 15, we'll be at the low point of 5. And again, then it just keeps up that pattern. So at 20, you're back in the middle. At 25, you're at the high point. At 30, you're back at the middle. At 35, you're at the low point on the graph. And at 40, hey, we're back in the middle. So that's going to be two periods of that function that describes your height on the Ferris wheel. So it's easy to see that the maximum height is going to be a height of 65 units, or 65 feet in this case, right? Because we were using feet. So the low, they didn't ask for it, the closest you'll get to the ground on the Ferris wheel will be 5 feet. So that's all there is to it. Again, to do these, those are pretty much the three or four things I think about. The amplitude, I think about the period, I break it up so that I get my increments, and then I think about that midline. Again, it gives me something nice and symmetrical. Again, go above it, go below it. Again, you go above it by the amplitude, and you go below it by the amplitude, and then you're in business.